One way that we can describe matter is by using color. Color is the way that different objects can appear, such as brown, blue, red, yellow, green, or blue, based off of the amount of light an object either absorbs or reflects. Absorb is kind of like a fancy word for sucking in something or taking in, and reflect is the opposite. When you think about a reflection, what you're seeing is your image bounced back into your eye when you look into a mirror. So we see certain colors based off of the amount of light that objects either absorb, take in, or reflect, bounce off of them. For example, objects that appear red reflect or bounce off red light and absorb, take in, all other colors of light. Objects that appear blue reflect blue light and absorb all other colors of light. To help better explain this phenomenon of how we see color, let's take a look at a clip from a brain pop and then meet back up.
Well, the sun produces a few different types of light. We divide them up based on their wavelengths. That's the distance between the tops of a wave. Infrared and ultraviolet wavelengths are invisible to us. To humans, anyway. People can see the wavelengths that make up visible light. All mixed together, they appear white. But white light contains a whole range or spectrum of wavelengths. When they're split apart, our eyes register them as different colors.
So friends, when light from the sun travels to Earth, we learned that it does so in the form of something called a wavelength. And when those wavelengths travel, they're seen as white light. When that light hits an object can either absorb or take in that light from the sun, or reflect or bounce off that light. If that object takes in only some of that wavelength, that light from the sun, what happens is our wavelength splits up or breaks. And that's what we saw in our video, how when our wavelengths are split up, we see a whole range or spectrum of colors, which looks like a rainbow. So what happens when we see an object as a certain color is the wavelengths from the sun are hitting that object, and that object is absorbing or taking in some of that wavelength, but reflecting other parts of it. And the reflected part of the wavelength that we see is represented in the color of that wavelength that is not absorbed. So the wavelength breaks up, and what's reflected back into our eye is the part of the wavelength that was not absorbed or sucked in by that object. That object isn't absorbing or taking in any of that wavelength's light, then all of that wavelength is bounced back to our eye, and we see that object as white. Alternately, when an object absorbs or takes in all of that wavelength's light, we see that object as black. Now, with these wavelengths, with this light, we also get heat. So, when an object is absorbing that wavelength, it's also sucking in a little bit of that heat. When it's reflecting that wavelength, it's also bouncing off some of that heat. This is why we wear lighter colors in summer and darker colors in winter. Those lighter colors reflect the sun's light and the sun's heat, whereas those darker colors absorb it. So the darker a color is, the more of that sun's energy or heat it's sucking in. When we begin building our ice pop coolers, are we going to want to use materials that are made from lighter colors that reflect the sun's light and therefore reflect the sun's heat? Or are we going to want to use dark colors that will absorb the sun's heat and make our ice pop cooler or our device warmer? Think about it. Do we want our ice pop coolers to be hot, or do we want to keep them cold or chill so that our ice pop can remain chilled? In addition to color, matter can also be described by texture. Texture is the way that something feels when we touch it with our skin. An object might feel smooth, bumpy, soft, scratchy, even slippery. How might you describe these next three objects if you could only use texture to identify them? Now that you know a little bit more about how color and texture helps us identify matter, think about the different objects that you use every day and how the color and texture of those objects help you identify them and help them be more useful. Think about the color and textures that you would want to use now on your device that you're going to create to keep our ice pops cold. What do you think that device should look like? And how do you think that device should feel when you touch it with your skin?